Hey everybody. I am trying to give you an update from my car. I am keeping watch at the moment. Let's see where to start. We have been out of touch because geez. They stole our camera. It does put us at a disadvantage as far as, how much entertainment we can provide, but it's certainly an advantage as far as how much complaint we can file. So I am just checking to see if we have any viewers live. This is from my monitor, and it is harder for me to use. I am attempting to figure it out. I'm having to light with a flashlight. Okay, so we may have a viewer. Yay. It'd be great if you said hello. Looks like El Damian was on and I didn't know, but it's great to see you, El Damian. So say hi to us and maybe ask questions because we've had a lot happen. Maybe I can give you some record if you didn't catch it from when I was telling the police who watch our station that I am going to sue. You need to think about this. We're not threatening a lawsuit to be malicious. We're threatening a lawsuit to stop this practice. It is really important that we have free press, free protest, freedom of expression, freedom of religion and to express our religion. All of those things are part of our vigil, whether it's a person's religion that they're expressing, or their free speech, their demonstration right, or the media in our case. And when 99 is consistently arrested just for having signs or for having his belongings, when he's obviously complying with lawful orders that he's given, we've been documenting. You cannot say, take my computer and have all of the information and have it go away. Everything that's being done is recorded, and it's a great body of evidence of harassment. And it's not just the police force. The police are following an order, apparently, that's coming down from City Hall. And it seems to be that they want us gone, despite the just cause of trying to attract attention to this need to get people off of the streets and change policy so that they're not endangered as they are on the street. That's a very just cause. It'd be very easy for City Hall to get behind. And instead, they're attacking our protest. So, I don't know if you guys in City Hall have been following, but Occupy protesters win in court. We've been successful in court. We're going to continue to be successful. We're beating criminal charges. We're getting, precedent set for you to be scrutinized. The Department of Justice is looking at the force being used, largely because of the protests, and definitely including them. And now we're in the process of filing lawsuits. So, right now, I have heard that the police have come in and begun to seize any possessions that they can grab just because we're on a sidewalk by trying to say that somehow, by us being on a sidewalk, they've rezoned it. That's clearly in response to us. And no matter what City Hall tries to say about how they had their traffic engineers look at the situation and rezone it, the fact is that they were doing it because there were protesters here. And after that, they're rezoning it again, apparently, so that we can't be anywhere on City Hall ground to protest. And that is not going to fly legally. And considering our media had gotten right up in the paper on Saturday, and published in Saturday and Sunday, and then Monday you've confiscated our camera and our internet. I don't know if you realize the significance of that, but you are attempting apparently to stop our voice, and we're very passionate about this subject. It's very important. This is not a frivolous thing. If you noticed that I had been out here every other night for 5 months and I suffered, I did. I suffered out here. There were mental and physical things that happened to me and trauma that I endured about being on the street that is just a portion of what a person who lives out here could deal with. Because for them, they can't just go home. They have no feeling of relief anticipation. For me, it was kind of like being a tourist because I knew that at some point I could go into my home and hide from things that were horrible that I, you know, went through. But those things that I went through, in part, are documented on camera. And so that kind of courage is not just me. I'm only speaking to what I endured, but I've seen it with other people. And this is extremely important to us. So this is extremely illegal of you to try to stop us. And we are going to fight. This isn't something that can be won by harassment. You're going to have to try a new tactic. Something of a negotiation. And I don't mean a lip service lawyer with continued harassment by police. I mean a ceasefire on us, a truce, some kind of meeting of our lawyer with your lawyer and actually being serious about it. But you will not be harassing us away. You can actually do us a lot of harm and continue to do us a lot of harm, but it makes us stronger. It galvanizes us and it brings the community in and it gives us media attention and public sympathy. And the more you bully us, the worse it will be. And I'm happy to go down that road because I think that this gives us an opportunity to possibly expose the truth about what this police department and City Hall, specifically City Hall, is actually about right now. I wouldn't blame individual officers very often. There's only a couple for me personally down here that I am holding as people responsible for this as much as City Hall. For the most part, I'm looking at this policy and this whoever is directing it, and we will find that out, who is directing this harassment. So, that's my soapbox about what kind of thing we've been targeted for and what I'm going to do about it. If I didn't do it, if somehow I had been silenced, someone else will. Like I said, we have a lot of evidence, and every single harm being done to us is just adding to that. I am giving an opportunity here, since I believe that the police do listen to our stream. The opportunity is to not go down this path, since you already know, you should know, that it is a futile path to try to bully us away. I would not. That's why I'm explaining what it was like for me to be here in the winter last year and through thick and thin, and there were some pretty thick and thin times. So if you can imagine trying to throw a bully at me or take things that I care about, you know, possessions and sentimental or things to cripple my ability, like a phone or a car or whatever else you might try to do. Those things will not deter me. And for every me, there's another somebody, and for every them, there's another somebody. We're a larger family, I think, than you realize, of people who just are here to stand for justice and will not be stopped by bullies. So I think it's time for some monetary compensation, time for some damage to come down on these wrongdoers for damages, hopefully, possibly some reconsideration about who is on the police force. Although I know that you guys, if you're laid off, you just get paid, but it would send a message at least. And so, but like I said, I'm aware of very few individuals on the police force. I'm actually one of those police sympathizers in some way, where I feel like if we could just let police do a real job of fighting crime, that we wouldn't attract a certain bad element. If they were actually the Mr. Rogers neighborhood kind of cops I'm hoping for, if that was how we dealt with law, is looking at it as protecting the people, then we could have some very admirable, courageous people on the force. And maybe you guys watching are some of those people, and maybe you're tired of what is happening, where City Hall is using you as bullies and as janitors for people. And I don't know if you've thought about this, but homelessness is increasing. The more that you push people out to the dark alleys, the sicker they get, the longer they stay out there. The more that they are jailed, the worse their circumstances are, the longer they stay out there. People are going out into the street and they're not coming out. Normally, they should be able to save up rent for a little bit and then get back out. But you are destroying their lives. You're endangering them. And why is the mayor throwing cops at this problem? He can't seem to do anything with, you know, I guess $50 million only buys 130 units of housing. 150 buys, you know, 150 million buys less than 500 units of housing, like 400 units, maybe less, 300. Can you believe that? Do you understand what's going on here? No matter how much money that they put on this problem, it's still existing, and all they're doing is trying to have it out of sight, out of mind, using police. And so your job will become 100% full-time harassment of people instead of protecting and serving anyone. I just don't believe that all police want that. So, you know, I have a lot of friends who hate police. They won't talk to them. They have endured things that they can't forgive. And maybe it's my white privilege and my privilege as somebody who stayed in the back of the line that's talking when I say I still have some faith in individuals. So I apologize to my comrades who have been harmed by police this way and who can't possibly understand my point of view that it's worth trying to reach out to human beings. But my lawsuit is not going to be malicious. Fighting for the right of a policeman or policewoman to actually have a job that is just as much for you. So when I sue the city, I hope that you're rooting for me. But if you are a bully and you think that you're going to stop me or anyone else from this protest, considering how important this is, you're wrong. You're going to dig yourself a deeper hole. Those amount of damages, those amount of reprimand that may come down on you out of a political pressure, out of a huge lawsuit, that kind of thing. You're just doubling down. If you continue to harass, you're doubling down on a losing bet. I don't understand. Haven't you learned that we cannot be intimidated? We can't be stopped when one person is taken out, we resent it, but another person comes back in. There's a lot of people who care about this. I don't understand how you're not seeing this. Tomorrow morning, I had better not witness what people witnessed. I guess that's this morning. What they witnessed yesterday. Just grabbing as much stuff as you can. Being so blatant in your seizure. It's illegal. Just mellow out. Wait for some kind of, you know, insist on some kind of negotiation between lawyers, some kind of discussion. I'm still going to sue, but I won't be suing you for the horrible amount of damage that you plan on doing this week to other people, including myself. It'll just be for whatever's occurred so far, which is pretty significant because you shut down media for a day right after we were printed in the paper, and it is obviously correlated or just a very unfortunate accident on your part. But I don't think so, considering the PPB gave a statement and knew that it was going to be printed Saturday and then confiscated a camera and our internet broadcasts. So you have given us ammunition to show that you are squashing not just the protest but the media. So thank you for that. Now, tomorrow, if there's anything taken and you think that nobody's watching, we're going to have coverage. Whether you see it or not, you are not going to find every camera. You're not going to be able to stop people's testimony. You're not going to get to anybody and stop them from talking. I don't even personally believe that most officers would feel like doing such a thing, but there are bullies among you. Maybe those bullies shouldn't be setting the tone of the entire police force and your jobs. It should be an exception. They should be on their way out. So I guess bring it on. So for you viewers, I just went on some rant talking to cops. I'm really trying to give them a chance. Anyway, like I said, I'm still suing. I want you to know that Vigil TV is still on the air, that we've had some interruption. But in the meantime, we're still videotaping. We're still having live streamers come by. This particular channel may be a little light the next couple days, but we have a YouTube channel, so if we have anything to upload, it will be there. YouTube is easily viewed as the archive on VigilTV.com. So if you have not already, please look at VigilTV.com. As always, we're looking for our donations for the Vigil physical items, which are on VigilTV.com, even though it's not directly related to VigilTV, which is the media that a few of us are doing. We are providing an avenue for you to donate to the Vigil directly, suggestions on who to contact. It can be us, it can be people here that you just drive by. These are gift certificates, these are physical needs. There's also Vigil TV if you want to keep this media on the air. We need to pay our monthly bill every month, and we do have a WePay for that. So thanks for helping to keep us going. This is really a time. When I say double down, this is the time for us to double down. We are going to be doing more presence and more demonstrating and more documenting. So thank you for tuning in. I'm sorry we didn't get anybody to chat with us on the stream. I'm going to take a look and see how many viewers that we have. I saw it somewhere on here. Let's see. Well, I think it's one. It says one out of zero. One divided by zero. Hey, isn't that infinity? We have infinite viewers. See, we're still going strong. Love you guys. Hopefully, 99 will be back up on his Ustream. I am working on that process. If he's not, though, we will upload the physical videos because we do have that capability. And we'll have some live stream support. We love OPDX Live for all the backup and all the assistance so much. So, you know, I thank both channels, but right now I've been reaching out to a lot of OPDX Live folks and very much appreciate it. Also, I will be doing a stream panel, 5 p.m. Pacific, not a panel, I'm sorry, and it's called otherpossibilities.org, maybe, but if you look up, it's Other Possibilities Network, and that will be 5 p.m. where I will be talking about Vigil TV. So if you could tune into that online, it would be great. I love those people. Artister and Zena and some other people have been really good to us, and we know them because of Rise PDX. So thank you both, live stream folks, for all the connections and all the support, and hope you guys are watching. So go to OccupyPortland.org and look at where it says media, and sometimes we are rebroadcast on those media outlets. So whenever possible, we love it for you to be in our chat room, but whenever possible, to support our live stream channels on OccupyPortland.org by being there. Thank you. We'll check it on you later. I'm going to stay here. I'm going to stay here so are other people, and we will talk to them in the morning. We will be most likely live streaming when the cops get here at 7. And either they are going to reassess their tactic and decide not to amp it up, or they're going to be as bad or worse as they were yesterday morning. Or they're going to wait for some of us to leave who have video equipment and be sorry to find out that we have people with cameras that they are not going to be able to silence. I've made arrangements to make sure that even though we may have some difficulty with our live stream, that we have plenty of cameras and a lot of probable live streamers coming in. We're not going to be short on video and probably live video. So you guys keep watching. And like I said, there's YouTube for us. There's also opdxlive.org potential coverage here if we are not on our Ustream. So tune in. Go to vigiltv.com. Bye.